a lovely day. The weather is amazing. It's really dry. We feel great. Back here with the 8.6. Continuing the preparations for halfway hangs and also just making a nice, acceptable street car that won't fall apart. How is everything going, Chris?
Yeah, it's good. We're taking a small deviation from practical mods to install these N-style horns.
N-style horns. Where'd you get them from?
Got them from 8.6 Fighters in NZ.
Oh yeah. What is this?
It's like the controller box. So
wait, do they make like a weird sound?
There's multiple settings.
Oh, so let's go.
8.6 Fighters is very nice, and he did English translations for how to wire it up.
100. Gonna figure out how it works. Sully put it together. I'm terrible at wiring, so it's gonna be Chris putting it together for the most part.
So it says, press the horn button to switch the sounds. Pattern one is crossfire. Pa, 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 pa. Pattern two is echo. Pattern three is standard.
Pa.
Just put me in your grill, bro. I'm a pretty good horn. Oh my god. Is it?
This is echo. You got echo?
What the fuck? Wait, were you changing it?
Yeah, if you tap the horn over and over again, it changes it.
What the heck? Is that like a practical horn function or is it just... Sorry.
That is loud.
Yeah.
Well,
this would be perfect for telling AU Falcons to get out of your way on the track.
That's crazy.
Thank you.
Horn install done.
Oh, true. And then you just got to tuck the wires out. That's the thread there.
Oh, yeah, I can put it on there. Kind of want them to be visible though.
Or you can go one here, one there.
I like them together like that.
True.
I can make it as hard.
You're asking a lot out of that bolt and this this radiator support.
That's true. Oh,
so if you haven't seen any of the previous videos, context for this radiator support is that it's been chopped a lot. Doesn't look like a stock one because it had to fit in intercoolers and stuff for an SR20 because that's what this car used to have, and also a turbo 4AG. But now it's gone back to OEM, which is how it should be. Mounting it on the Australian passenger side. Trying to allow, kind of still let airflow go in.
I need to mount this little box somewhere.
Mate, what about all these these holes that are meant to be holding your fender on? But
they're fine.
You can put it there.
It's a quick release fender.
Alright, so everyone who's been watching my videos, just want to say thank you so much for watching and sending me nice messages, telling me that my videos are enjoyable to watch. I appreciate it. Chris appreciates it. It doesn't show that he appreciates it, but he does deep down. Yeah, thank you again.
Putting the wire into a sheath.
Just trying to do a fresh install, you know?
Fresh install.
The next stage of this build would be like, not a wire tuck, but just like, because even there's all like aircon plugs that aren't being used. Like, there's so many plugs just hanging that aren't being used.
And the whole deal down in that corner by the battery, where like sometimes the car doesn't start.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I guess
tidying all that stuff up would be handy.
Yeah. I guess it's the old do it once, do it right type deal.
For sure, and I just left it because it's stock, so I was just like, fuck, I'll just leave it stock.
Okay, so there's ground done down there. The sheath of cable that you would have seen before is running just through this area here underneath the radiator support. And now it's just cable management. Horns are mounted. Ran the wire through, control box is zip tied under there with the ground you can see, and all works. So yeah, wheels are coming off because we're going to do some brake pads. Chris has got these Project Mu high performance Japanese brake pads. I think the advantage of having them in the back is that you get heaps good bite with the handbrake.
Yeah.
And then the front is just a nice like D1 spec extreme rear. Okay, yeah, they're the rear pads and then racing front pads.
Wayne, who fixed the rust on the car, reckons that his mate had an 86 with Project Mu D1 pads in the rear, and he would just like tap the brake pedal and it would initiate drift, like, because the bike is so crazy.
Running free 86 style.
Yeah, so theoretically, not that that's definitely gonna happen, but the brakes on this are already terrible, as we've learned, so any bite will help.
Yeah, braking drift is pretty common technique with 86 drivers.
Yeah,
I don't think, like, you know, it's as common in other cars.
You don't see 86 drivers using too much handbrake. Obviously they use a fair bit of handbrake, but you never see an 86 with a hydro or anything.
But you know? Yeah, but you never see, like, S chassis drivers do braking drift where they just tap the brake and it slides. I feel like they're always, you know, clutch kicking or like feint initiating.
These are the pads, they're iconic green, D1 spec.
Nice. It's a new day. Check this out. The Falcon's been exploded. The reason behind this is... It's dank.
This is the cheapest tow rig in history. It's a very cheap tow rig and it's just disgusting. So I'm gonna pull the whole rubber mat out and clean it.
There's like 45 different species of dog hairs in that car, as long as like a million other unidentified substances. So I think he's gonna be driving out for like at least 12 hours. And yeah, don't, like, that shit'll stick onto you by the end of that. Anyway, this is a continuation. So yesterday you would have seen doing the brakes. It's all done now.
New Project Mu D1 spec extreme pads in the rear.
From what I've learned about them, braking drift initiations, not that I can do them or know anything about them, but they're meant to be really good for brake drift initiations. Just kind of the old school style of 86 driving you see a lot in like running free 86 videos, where he kind of just downshifts, coming into a corner, downshifts, taps on the brakes, and it just tips in itself. So yeah, maybe you'd learn a new style of initiation with that setup.
Oh my gosh.
What? Okay, I saw this and I was like, what the f-? That's like fresh drool, I'm not touching it. But it turns out a dog walked past and drooled on it recently. I thought Chris had been doing some weird shit behind my back. Gloves are on.
Fucking gross. Cutting slits in the carpet to creep.
I'll pull it out this way.
Actual cockroach running around in here.
Oh, there's a speaker cable.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on here with all this, but...
Yep.
Is that how you do it?
Oh, I'm doing it.
I've never seen this method before, but... Pissed all over the carpet, vacuum the chairs.
Ew! Ew! Brother, that is nasty.
Altezza lights in the Falcon. Chris picked this up off Facebook Marketplace last night for $100. And I reckon they look great.
Little dress up.
Little glow up. Verdict?
I hate it, but I love it. I like the one halogen, one LED light.
It looks straight out of Lilo and Stitch.
Grill or grill this?
Yeah, the LED wasn't working on this side, so you put the halogen back in. Bit how you going. Very how you going. The lights look cool. Except you're just putting more turd on a turd, but it's like nice turd, kind of. Like different turd.
Lipstick on a pig, bro.
Yeah. But it's like cheap lipstick, like.
Like not good lipstick.
Nice. Oh my god. Wow, it's so, so sturdy. Is the brakes working?
No.
Okay. Wait, a little bit more, just to get in front of the sign. Yeah, that'll do.